Welcome, guys. Coach Dill here from Clemente Martinez Elementary School and also Coach Dill TV from YouTube. Glad you guys could tune in with us today. We're going to be giving you guys some resources from Open Phys Ed for their National Field Day, which is scheduled for May 8th. We also have a hashtag HISD Virtual Field Day on May 15th. It should be airing on HISD at Home TV on Channel 20. Hope you guys can tune in. I hope that this video is very resourceful and I hope that you guys have fun. You guys can tune in to that if you want to get practice for our hashtag HISD Virtual Field Day we're having on May 15th. And there is going to be an opening ceremony on May 7th at 7:30 p.m. There's going to be a link down in the description. There's also going to be a link that you can see on the screen that you can copy down or take a picture of so you guys can log in for yourselves. Also, we have a team of PE teachers who have been working so hard to bring you guys this video. We want to make sure you guys had all the resources that you need. A big and huge shout out to Open Phys Ed for allowing us to collaborate with them and use their materials to bring you guys this first ever virtual field day. There's also going to be some resources that you can see here, give you some demonstrations and some explanations of what games we're going to be doing for HISD. There's tons of games that you can do for National Field Day with Open Phys Ed on May 8th. So you can get those games started, practice on those games. Main thing you want to focus on is being safe. Make sure you're playing by the rules. Make sure everybody's doing what? Having fun. Always have fun, guys, when you participate in your games. Always be safe. And also make sure you stay in a safe area. We want to make sure that you guys have everything you need so you can have fun with your families. Field Day is one of the most fun times. We do not want you guys to miss out on that. Parents, students, please send your pictures of your kids participating and of you guys participating in Field Day. Also, don't forget to send us a picture of your scorecards. We would like to see those. Send those to your respective coaches. We would like to thank Open Phys Ed for the resources. Here's a step-by-step guide how to go along with the National Field Day. Here's a scorecard, an example of a scorecard for your games. Also, they even have student contracts if you need them. You have coaches from all over the district who are putting this field day together for you guys just so you guys can not miss out on this opportunity and not miss out on the things that we have planned for you guys. May 8th is the date. Hope you guys can tune in. May 15th is the HISD field day. Hope you guys can tune in on HISD at Home TV. Enjoy this video. But first, before you get into the video, you must always warm up. Let's get the warm up going with Coach Dill. Now, here is a Houston ISD Virtual Field Day slideshow. As you can see here, this is HISD disclaimer and waiver of liability. Okay, read that when you get a chance to. Also, these are the list of games that will be played during our National Field Day or HISD Field Day. Want to create a scorecard, a field day scorecard? Make sure you can make it legible for everybody to see and make sure you record your scores. Field Day games. Backboard Banquet. Fan of War. Flip Your Lid. Keep It Up. Milk Jug Relay. Paper Plane Cornhole. Soccer Ski Ball. Spoon Relay. Towel Flip Challenge. Wash Your Hands Relay. Here are some links that you can use to go to these demonstration games. A game that was not mentioned was Fan Favorite. And you'll see here later on in the video by Coach Licio. Here are some things to do. And now we're going to check out some field day events with Coach Searcy.
Throughout the video, make sure you keep an eye out for cards like this from Open Phys Ed.
Hello, I'm Coach Cersei from Rucker Elementary. Today I'm going to demonstrate some field day games. On May 8th, OpenPhysEd.org is having a virtual field day. So you have to sign up your school. May 8th, OpenPhysEd.org. So the first game I'm going to demonstrate is called Milk Jug Relay. All you need is a gallon of milk. It can be a gallon of water, whatever you have in your household to do this game. So also I created my scorecard. I'm going to give myself a score because with the milk jug relay, I have 1 minute to travel, and I'm going to tally up how many times can I travel in 1 minute. Every time I travel back to my start sign, I give myself 1 point. Okay, so I have my gallon of water and my gallon of oil. I'm going to start here, and I'm going to start my timer. Ready, go. So I completed Milk Jug Relay. I had 12 points. So on my score sheet, I'm going to write 12. So hopefully you enjoyed this game and you can do this game with your family. What do you need for this game? All you need is 3 sheets of paper to make a paper airplane. You can have a laundry basket. You can have a bucket so your airplanes can go inside of the bucket or basket. So this is how the game goes. You have 1 minute to try to land your airplane inside of the basket. If you land your airplane inside the basket, you give yourself 2 points. If you are able to hit the basket, then you give yourself 1 point. Also, when I'm timing myself for that 1 minute, at the end, I'm going to come back to my score sheet, find my game, paper, playing corn, and then give myself my points on my score sheet. So let's go demonstrate the game. Okay, so I have my 3 paper airplanes that I made. So get ready, let's start, go. So you see, that game was a little challenging, but never give up. Keep doing it, keep doing your best, and the most important thing, have fun. So I had 2 points, 1 point, one each for touching the basket, and then my airplane did go inside. So my tally up points will be 4 total points. So our next field day game is called Soccer Ski Ball. With this game, you have to use your feet, kick the sock inside of either the laundry basket or the bucket or the Tupperware. If you kick it in your laundry basket, that is 1 point. If you kick it in the bucket, it's 5 points. If you kick it in the smaller, which could be Tupperware or it can be a smaller bucket, that will be 10 points. At the end of the game, we'll tell you our points. Let's go get ready to play. Okay, so now I have my 10 socks. I have my laundry basket here. I have another smaller basket, and then I have a smaller bucket. So the smaller bucket is gonna be 10 points, and then the bucket here, 5 points, and my laundry basket is gonna be 1. So remember, it's called soccer ski ball. You have to use your feet to kick. There's no timer for this game. When your socks run out, then the game is over. So I'm starting the game. Trying to kick it inside of the laundry basket. So the soccer ski ball, that was a bit challenging for me. However, you keep going. The point is just to have fun. I only made 2 goals, so I'll give myself 2 points. Hi everyone, I'm Coach Cersei. Today is our National Virtual Field Day. So I will be demonstrating 3 field day games today. Today I want to go over some goals. No matter when you're playing games, you want to make sure you always find a safe area, free of objects, free of nails, free of maybe a sofa or a chair. So just make sure you're in a safe area. We're going to also today learn about different skills like underhand, maybe a little volleying skills. Also, we also are going to learn how can you teach this the game to your family. It's also what we're going to learn today. At the end of the lesson, you should be able to, again, teach those games to your family. We want to also remember to display good sportsmanship and always treat others with respect during any play time or any activity, okay? So today, these are going to be my three games. My first one I'm going to do is called Towel Flip Challenge. That will be my first game that I'm going to demonstrate. And then my second game, Backboard Bank It, and then Keep It Up will be my last game. You're going to need to create a scorecard. This is my scorecard I created, and at the end of each game, I will be coming back to my scorecard because I need to give myself a score. So get ready. Let's go have some fun. For Towel Flip Challenge, what do you need? First type of equipment is going to be, all you need is a towel for this. Okay? You lay your towel flat on the surface of the grass, the floor, wherever you're doing this challenge, okay? Also, the objective of the game is to flip your towel as many times as you can with both of your feet standing on the towel. So I will demonstrate this, okay? You can take small steps from one part of the towel to another. However, you can only move when you have both feet on the towel. You cannot move if you have one foot off the towel. So the objective of the game is to have both feet on the towel, and then you can flip your towel. Also, your goal is try to make the towel as small as possible. That is the challenge, and you have 1 minute to do this. So 1 minute to challenge yourself to flip the towel however many times. Remember, with both feet standing on the ground or the surface that you have your towel on. So let me demonstrate. So I'm coming back to my scorecard. With the towel flip challenge, it's no point. So can you do the challenge under a minute? Yes, I did the challenge under a minute. Then I just give myself a happy face. For our next challenge, this game is called Backboard Bank It. What equipment you need? You need a laundry basket. If you do not have a laundry basket, use any kind of bucket you have, Tupperware in your home, whatever you have in your house. Also, you need 5 pair of socks, and you need a flat surface. Because the objective of this game is to throw your sock against a flat surface like a backboard and then bank it in your laundry basket to make a shot. So like a bank shot in basketball where you bank the ball in the backboard or layup and you bank it in the hoop or in the basket. So this game is similar to that. So this is the points. You have, again, 1 minute to do this. Also, distance. You want to make sure you 5 feet away from your laundry basket. But to modify it, you can come closer if you are, I say, under 5, you can come closer. Just say 3 feet if you're under 5 years old. So, again, once you bank it in there, that's your points. You give yourself 1 point. How many points can you get in a minute? So, let's play. Let's go. So let's add up our points. Going back to my scorecard, backboard bank, I had 15 points. Also, you notice when I'm demonstrating, you can do underhand toss, or if you want to do overhand, that's fine. I say you try what will make you be successful. So our next challenge is called Keep It Up. The equipment you need 2 balloons, or if you don't have a balloon, you can use scarves, okay? So the objective of the game is to keep your object up, your balloon or scarf. You want to keep throwing it, volleying up like to the sky as many times as you can in 1 minute. Also, you can use 1 balloon or you can use 2, you decide. So if you use 1 balloon, you're still just going to volley it up in the air for 1 minute. How many points you can get every time you hit it, that's a point. One, two. Every time you hit it, it's a point. If you do two balloons, then you have to alternate hands. So alternate right hand, left hand, right, left. Okay? So again, you decide what is easier for you to do. So let me show you how to play the game. Let's go. Back to my scorecard. I had 42 strikes for Keep It Up. And also, I was alternating my right hand and my left hand with my palm facing up. You could also strike it like this as well with your palm showing to the sky. So I guess you decide which one is easier for you. So our lesson review. Remember, in the beginning lesson, I discussed this. So we want to remember. So now you should learn how to teach your family some field day games. Okay, when you're playing, you want to always demonstrate good sportsmanship. The challenge is to have fun and just have fun being active. Remember, 60 every day.
Thank you, Coach Cersei. Now let's check out some more field day events with Coach Sue.
You were made to be amazing. Hi, I'm Coach Sue, and I'm the elementary PE teacher at Wharton Dual Language Academy. Today, I'm here to teach you three games that you can play during our field day. Are you excited? I sure am. So let's get started. Our goals today deal with sportsmanship. During our first goal, we will recognize and explain the importance of manners and rules for healthy communication and treating others with respect. During our second goal, we will demonstrate effective listening skills. The first game that I'll be demonstrating is called Flip Your Lid. The equipment that you need for Flip Your Lid is a spatula and a plastic lid. You can use a plastic lid from a food container or one from a Tupperware container. Are you ready to learn how to play? Let's go. To get started with this game, you'll place your lid facing up on a table or floor. Get your spatula ready for some lid flipping. The object of this game is to flip your Tupperware lid upside down to earn points. Place the lid facing up on the table or floor, then slide the spatula under and flip the lid in the air. Let it land flat on the table or floor. You score a point for every lid that you flip upside down. 0 points if it lands right side up. Quickly reset the lid each time you flip it. You have 1 minute to see how many times you can flip the lid upside down. And don't forget, write your score down.
We have our two demonstrators. We have Wookie and we have Gabby. And they're going to give each other a high five because we always start off encouraging one another and using our positive manners. When I say go, they're going to demonstrate how to play Flip Your Lid. On your mark, get set, go. And you got to quickly pick up your lid and you get a point for every time the lid lands upside down.
Wow, that game was a lot of fun, wasn't it? Are you ready to learn about the second event? Okay, the second event that I'm going to teach you is called Wash Your Hands Relay. And you really need very little equipment for this game. You just need something that can mark off two endpoints of a line. You can use cones if you have them. You can use solo cups. You could even use sneakers. Now, the distance between your two end lines is about 12 feet. You can either walk that off 12 feet or you could actually get out and measure it. So I have a yardstick and we know that 1 yard is made up of how many feet? You're right, 3 feet. So how many groups of three do I need to create 12 feet? And you're right, four. I would just measure one, two, three, and then four to create my distance. And the last thing that you need is something to count off your seconds. There's a great song called 20 Seconds or More by Dougie Fresh, which talks about the importance of thoroughly washing your hands. But if you don't have access to music, no worries. You can use a timer on your watch, timer on your phone. So are you ready to learn how to play? Let's go.
To start this game, you need to create two end lines by setting your objects, like your cones, about 12 feet apart in an area that's safe for movement. Now is the time to play 20 Seconds or More by Dougie Fresh. This song teaches us how to wash our hands and to keep our family safe from disease. The object of this game is to move from line to line as many times as you can in 1 minute while pretending to wash your hands. You must walk, skip, or gallop. Running or jogging is not allowed. On the start signal, begin moving from line to line. Count each time that you move to an end line. On the stop signal, stop, and record your score on your scorecard. Our players, Gabby.
Hi.
And Wookie.
Hello.
Can you tell me, why is it important to have good listening skills?
So you know how to play the game.
Super. So in this game, our players have to choose a locomotor movement to perform while they're pretending to wash their hands. Wookie, what locomotor movement did you choose?
Chose galloping.
Awesome. And Gabby, what did you choose?
I chose skipping.
Super. So let's get our players at the start line. And when I say go, they'll start to compete. On your mark, get set, go.
Wow, that game was awesome. Are you ready to learn about the third event? Our third event is called the Spoon Relay. And for this game, you'll need something that will mark off your starting point and your checkpoints. You can use your cones, you can use a red solo cup, or you can even use your sneakers. You'll also need for this game a spoon and something to balance in your spoon. I used a golf ball, but you can use a small toy, you can use a marble, or if your parents will let you, you can even use an egg. Are you ready to get going? Yes, let's begin.
This game begins with setting a starting point and a checkpoint. The distance should be about 30 walking steps from beginning to end. At the start point, get ready by placing your object on your spoon and balance it. You have 1 minute to score points by completing laps with your object balanced on your spoon. At the start signal, move carefully from the starting point to the checkpoint and back again. That counts as one lap. Complete as many laps as possible without a drop. If you drop the object, stop walking, place it on the spoon, and begin again. You score 1 point for each lap completed without a drop. At the end of the game, write your score down on your scorecard. So we're back with our players, Gabby.
Hi.
And Wookie. And we're going to be playing the spoon relay. What items did you all choose to balance on your spoons?
An egg.
So they both have raw eggs, so let's hope that they don't drop them. So they're going to start at their starting points. And when I say go, they're going to balance their eggs on their spoons, down to their cones, and back. Ready, set, go. Great job. Gabby has one. Wookie has one.
Thank you, Coach Sue. Now let's check out some more field day events with Coach Lucio.
And here is our bonus game called Fan Favorite. Students and parents, please don't forget to send your scorecards and your pictures of your students having fun and your families having fun out there. We want to share this moment with you guys. It's a very special moment, the first virtual field day. Hope you're able to participate. Hope you have fun. Hope you're sweating. Hope you play 60. Hope you have all the energy in the world. Now go get you some water. Stay hydrated. Now, thank you for tuning in. We also want to thank Open Phys Ed and USA Games again for the opportunity to work on this collaboration and to bring you guys this video and make sure that you guys are actually having fun. Even with the circumstance right now, we're going to have fun. We're going to play 60 every chance we get.
Thank you, coaches, for putting this video together. A huge thank you for all the PE coaches from around the Houston ISD School District. A huge thank you to Open Phys Ed for allowing us to collaborate on this and to give you guys resources to bring virtual field day to you guys. We hope that you had a great time. We hope that you enjoyed this video, and we hope to see you guys again soon. Be safe.